Today, 25th February, we have Blessed Rani Maria, Indian Martyr. Blessed Rani Maria was born on 29th January 1954 as the second child of Pili and Elizwa of Vatalil in an ordinary peasant family. Her baptism was on 5th February 1954 at St. Thomas Church, Puluvari, and she was given the name Mariam after Mother Mary, the mother of Jesus. The godparents were her uncle Varki and grandmother Mariamma. Her God-fearing parents brought her up in Christian faith and charity along with their six other children. Rani Maria and joined the Franciscan Clarist congregation. Later on, her younger sister too joined her. From her infancy, her parents and grandparents made her understand the importance of prayer. Even at the young age, she regularly attended the Holy Mass and took part in the popular devotions. She frequented catechism lessons and practiced what she learned in her day-to-day life. During her schooling, she also found time to help her father in the work of the fields and her mother in her domestic duties. She showed keen interest in and special love towards the servants and found time to chat with them. During the final year of her school, Mary felt the call of the Lord to embrace the consecrated life. Her frequent visit to the nearby convent and acquaintance with the FCC nuns enabled her to make a decision to enter the Franciscan Clarist congregation. Mary had some anxiety about the reaction of her parents and relatives. One day, she plucked up courage and openly expressed her desire to join the convent. After various phases of formation, almost at 20 years of age, she made her first profession in Franciscan Clarist congregation on 1st of May 1974 under the new name Rani Maria. Her mistress testifies of Rani Maria in these words: "She always had a smiling face and was a smart girl. She did everything with perfection and had no complaints about anything. During her hours of work, her favorite ejaculatory prayer was Jesus. She kept up this habit of uttering the name of Jesus till her very last breath. In fact, she was heard repeating Jesus, Jesus, right up to the end of her death agony. Rani Maria was convinced about her missionary call. For greater efficiency in her work as a missionary, she realized that she has to master the language of the place. Accordingly, she bid farewell to the mission fields on 9th July 1975 and engaged in language study. Sister Rani Maria was appointed as a teacher for 2 years in St. Mary's School, Bijnor. During this period, after the teaching hours, she was engaged in social ministry. During the 9 years of service in Oragadi, Sister Rani Maria changed the face of Oragadi through the developmental activities carried out with the cooperation of the people of the locality. Then she was transferred to Udainagar. She arrived there on 18th May. As an experienced social worker, she made a thorough study of the tribals of the villages and realized that they had unconsciously fallen into the debt trap laid very cunningly by the Baniyas, tradesman of Udainagar. Those villagers had become over-dependent on the scrupulous moneylenders who devour their meager earnings and property. The poor were not aware of the grants that government had allotted for their socio-economic development. Through various conscientization programs, Sister Rani Maria made them aware of their rights and injustice perpetrated on them. Thus, poor of Udainagar became active citizens and started to free themselves from the bondage to their heartless money lenders. During the Panchayat election in December 1994, there was a clash between two fractions of Kannad village and those of Sister Rani Maria. Jeevan Singh instigated the police to take action against the poor, and police jailed some innocent ones. Sister Rani Maria, with the help of a good lawyer, got them out on bail and fought their case in court. Jeevan Singh was so infuriated as she thwarted his plans. He decided to get rid of her at any cost. He hired a thug and waited for an opportune moment. At 8:30 in the evening, 25th February 1995, Sister Rani boarded a bus for Indore. A group of three, Jeevan Singh, Dharmendra Singh and Sumadhar Singh, also boarded the same bus. The first two had done meticulous hatching of a plot to kill Rani Maria, while the third committed the horrible crime. When the bus reached a secluded spot, it stopped for a while for the passengers to ease themselves. The trio now went out, split open a coconut, and performed puja on the stone deity nearby. They came back to the bus and distributed the kernel among the passengers in a happy mood. Rani Maria asked him, "Why are you so happy and excited today?" As if answering her question, he stabbed her on her face and dragged her out of the bus and kept on stabbing her till he made sure that she was dead. All the while, Sister Maria kept on uttering just one word, "Jesus, Jesus." The co-passengers were afraid to intervene, frightened for their life. The two who masterminded the gruesome crime soon disappeared into the thick forest. The murderer was the last to flee the scene after inflicting as many as 54 wounds on Rani Maria. Powerful expression of this forgiving love was given by Rani Maria's younger sister, Sister Selmi Paul FCC, in what became national news. On 21st August 2002, rightly interpreting the mind of her sister, Sister Salmi visited Samundhar Singh, the assassin of Rani Maria, in the Indore Central Jail. On the occasion of the 8th death anniversary of Sister Rani Maria, 25th February 2003, her mother Elishwa visited the jail and kissed the hands of her daughter's assassin. No gesture of forgiveness could have been more eloquent. The FCC superiors who accompanied her also expressed their forgiveness. The little-known village of Udainagar, where Rani Maria's mortal remains were laid to rest, achieved overnight fame and a sea of mourners and admirers of the martyred nun visited the place on the funeral day and continue to visit it ever since. The words of Bishop Anathil, who officiated the funeral services, were really prophetic. Sister Rani Maria is a martyr. Her tomb will become a pilgrim center. She preached the good news of liberation to the poor. The people of this place will receive abundant blessings through her. The prophecy came true when Pope Francis approved the cause of her beatification on 23rd March 2017 and confirmed that Sister Rani Maria will be beatified on 4th November 2017 at Indore.